Minasande, konnichiwa, my name is Brennan, and this is my channel, Tokyo to LA.
I'ma pull up and I'm festin' on purpose. Hey, I'ma smoke the jelly, got honey burn.
I have acquired many experiences and footage during my travels, whether it be selling the seven seas with my buddies, or through awesome aerial footage on the beaches of Southern California. Oh yeah, I have a passion for exotic cars too.
I keep up with Sabrina, she walked too damn fast.
So this is my life. Parties in Tokyo, good times with friends, back to LA, beautiful views.
Was that pretty strong?
Did I mention I play college football?
War Bros in this bitch, King Harry.
You can catch me pretty much anywhere in the world.
Go ahead, do 360.
If you enjoyed this intro and would like to see more, check out the full version in the intro only video.
Let's do this.
You get the bag and fumble it, I get the bag and flip it and tumble it. Straight out the lot, 300 cash,
can't look okay with
a blunt in it. Little mama a thot, and she got ass, that she gon' fuck up a bag. Pull up to the spot.
Yeah, I'll do that trick again, that old back spinning one. That one's nice.
You ain't got the gift of gab and just talk to talk. Don't. That's how you end up outlining bright chalk. Head chopped off. They see his head cause a lot. I see his head.
Damn, it's lit.
Can't walk the walk, don't talk the talk. But jokes.
すいません. とってもごめんなさいね.
Alright, so I'm back in the Hermosa Beach area. I think it's Redondo. I'm not really sure. But yeah, I'm back. Well, it's a nice day today, so I decided to walk my ass to my local store, pick up some stuff, because I enjoy cooking food. You know, it tastes good and it's relatively cheaper. I recently received a comment to discuss more about my background and my experiences while I was in the Navy. So I was thinking, which story would be very interesting to tell that stands out? Because I have a lot. So, came up with one. This happened, I say, because once you go to boot camp, you, everybody goes through like their general training, right? And within a particular branch, in my case it was the Navy, within a specific branch there's multiple of jobs. You can be a boatswain's mate. You can be, which like really does like hands-on, paying the ship, pretty much work like a slave. But you can be like me, I was quartermaster. Sounds kind of funny, but I worked in the navigation department, so I worked, it's 2017 now, so I work with a lot of electronics. So if you know what a Garmin Nuvi is, the GPS, a lot of cars have them, GPS units. That's pretty much what all I monitored while I was in the Navy. Very easy job. Only reason why it's hard for people to get is because it's hard for like the qualifications to get that job. That's all it is. If you're qualified, then boom. Everything else is downhill. Literally, just like what I'm doing right now, everything's downhill. So, went through my normal like general like military training, and that was if I remember correctly, I think that's 2 months or a month or something like that. I can't remember specific the times. However, when you graduate basic training, it's different for different different branches. They call it different stuff. Once you actually graduate, then your job that you picked, then after that your graduation, you have to go to a school and learn that specific trait or job. So for instance, and it's actually really cool, it's a cool process, because let's say your school is in Florida, then they'll give you a ticket the day of your graduation, say, hey, you're flying out in like 2 weeks, don't do nothing stupid. And for the Navy, their boot camp is in Chicago, so I was in Chicago for basic training for I think it was a month or 2 months or something. It's weird, I can't remember the exact time. However, for me to learn my job, my specific rate, or I know a lot of branches call it MOS, it's the same thing as a rate. I stayed in Chicago because my school was across the street from the actual general military training. So everybody gets the basic military training with the exception of your specific job. You have to go to a school for that. So some of my friends went to Florida, some of my friends went to Hawaii. It just depends on what job or rate MOS you that you choose. So there's a misconception that all military boot camps are like really tough and intense training with people yelling at you, like this. But Navy's not really like that. It's more of like focusing on marching and walking in straight lines, like this. My fridge is completely empty, so I'm buying all breakfast items and a few lunch items at my local Vons. Word of advice, don't shop on an empty stomach. Damn, rolled up on some donuts.
Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Baby, let's go and have rich sex. Make a little love, have rich sex.
Yeah, yeah.
Baby, let's go and have rich sex. Baby, girl, let's have some rich sex. I'ma keep an AP, I don't wanna do it. We can keep an AP, I don't wanna do it. You can keep it belly on with a.
Damn, it's lit.
You don't wanna get to it. When you look down, see my chains on. When you look down, see my chains on. When you ride on, see my chains on.
Most for naval boot camp is like, it's kind of like an act. They're just applying a lot of stress on you because although it's majority of it's admin, it can become stressful once you actually get to the quote fleet and you're on board ships and whatnot. The amount of work that you have to do, the so-called workload is, it can be a lot for a lot of individuals. So they try to break you mentally when you're there.
I must break you.
Damn!
So when you graduate basic, general education, I guess you could say, for military training, it's like just basic knowledge everybody has to know. You can invite your family, and I'm sure if you got friends in the military, you'll see that, and specifically for the Navy, you'll see that. But a lot of people go out and they party, right? So it's like college. This is pretty much what it's like. When you live on base, you live in what's called a barracks room, which is equivalent to dorm rooms. So it's almost exactly the same, except like SAT scores and ASVAB scores don't really play a big role. The weekends, there's like a curfew in place, and you gotta tell like people who are in charge of you what you plan on doing, because we're in Chicago. You gotta tell them where you're gonna be at, what time you expect to be back, if you're gonna be drinking. A lot of rules are set, right? I mean, there should be, you're in the military. So, in fact, I think like when you first graduate from boot camp and you're going to school, you're supposed to be wearing your uniforms everywhere. So if you go to the mall, you'll see like people in their uniform, like they call them peanut butters, the brown top with black pants. Dorm slash barracks was in the shape of a U, and in the center of it was a smoke pit, or an area where you can just go out and smoke, and they just call it the pit. So people would go down there, and once curfew expired, you had to be back on the base. So if you went out to like, you know, actual Chicago and partied and stuff, you had to be back at a certain time unless you were given permission, aka you did a lot more paperwork to stay out late. So a lot of people go to strip clubs and stuff, or they go visit like some girl that they met at the mall or some shit, but as long as they're back by, I think it was like 12 midnight or something, you know, just for them to account for people, because we're talking about thousands of just like teenagers, you know, people who are like 17 all the way up to, I don't know, maybe 19, get all this money and stuff. Anyways, but most people never been away from home, so when they get there, they start acting wild. Like, girls gone wild, man. Girls is doing crazy stuff, man. So, like, when I say girls were just going wild, like, damn, girls were just going wild. It got so bad to the point where they had to, the dorm or the barracks that I was in, they had to change the floors. Like, floors 1 through 2 were all men, and then all the rest were all females. They're like, fuck it, no more. And then some compartments or some rooms were completely shut down because they found so many people in there just like doing it. They were doing that shit. But I'm not talking about that now. That would be for another story. Alright, so besides like checking for cleaning and stuff, like they would, you know, do like what's called inspections. They had like these mandatory assemblies, and I think there was like, it's called heritage something, but sometimes I would just hide in the closet because I am trying to go nowhere, because you would have to go to class, you'd be in school for 8 hours, and then you would have to assemble for like another 3 hour like heritage meeting or something like that to talk about like U.S. history, or you'll have a guest speaker from like the Pentagon or something random, you know. So they'll do that every other day. A lot of people just hid in their closets. They ain't trying to do that shit. So from this area, that's their smoke area, was in the center of three buildings that's shaped like a U. My building was in the center. Other two buildings were on the side. So when you're in the smoke pit, like when you look around, you can see a lot. You can see, if people wanted you to see them, you can see them. I noticed that, like, I don't know if it was like a welcoming call or what, but a lot of the new recruits, the females, they just leave their windows wide ass open. So whenever they're taking like showers and stuff, you could see them. And I think it was something to do with like popularity amongst the guys on the base, because eventually the ones that left their windows open would be like, they'd get the most attention from the guys that were living there. Oh, so-and-so so hot, blah 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 blah, that type of thing would occur. So I was just like, man, I think girls are just doing that shit on purpose. So at the time I was still big into skateboarding, and I had another friend who was trying to get into skateboarding, so he used to just hang out with me. On this particular time, my friend and I, we decided to take our skateboards, and I want to say that the hallway of where my room was to like all the way down to the end of the hall was probably from like where I'm standing all the way to like where that break is right there, that ledge thing. So it was pretty far, and I'm really good at manuals, so I used to always just take my board and just manual the length of the, they call it a P-way, but just manual the length of the hall in our dorm rooms. So I'm doing that, and my friend calls me over. He's just like, yo, come over here, check this out. And I'm just like, all right, what's up, man? So I go over there, and when I was there, I'm like, bro, what are you looking at, man? The angle of the building, so it's shaped like a U, right? And we just happen to be in the center. We're in the center, and it's shaped like a U. The angle of the building from where he was sitting at, he could see right inside somebody's room. And he's just like, yo, isn't that blah, 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 blah? Yo, this chick's butt-ass naked, man, just walking around. And I was like, bro, I told you, girls do that shit on purpose here. You know what I'm saying? Like, they want attention. I don't know what it is. It's something about that whole graduating and leaving the house. People just go bananas. Guys, too. So I was just like, damn, I'm finna take a look, too.
What's she doing?
Huh? So I go over there, and I went, and I was like, holy shit, like, clear as day. You can just see inside this girl. Like, not her, but inside her room. She's butt-ass naked. And I'm just like, damn. Like, she must be doing this shit on purpose. I'm looking down on the smoke pit area. There's, like, it's weird. Normally people look at stuff like that, but for this instance, I didn't see anybody noticing her. So maybe she just, like, really wanted the attention. So I was just like, damn, this is really crazy. Like, that's probably the, like, you know, really an attention grabber right there. Just flat out butt naked in front of the window. So I'm just like, whatever, bro. Get my board. I'm fucking skateboarding and shit. And then my homeboy didn't even leave. He just sits there. He just keeps looking at this girl. I'm just like, damn, man, you act like you've never seen a naked girl before. So I go back over. He's just looking at her. He's like, bro, she just put her towel on. I think she's fucking going to start getting dressed. Like, all right, whatever. Right as soon as I'm getting ready to leave, he's like, yo, she's going to the door. Goes to the door. I'm watching her do this. She goes to the door. Opens the door. A white guy walks in. He's like, oh, shit. Dude, this shit's about to get on, bro. He's like, yo, I can't believe this. We're about to watch this shit. Oh, my God. And I was like, damn, that's some crazy shit. Let me watch it. So we're just watching. They start going at it. And then they both get up. They both go to the door. black dude walks in. And I was just like, what the hell is going on? Clear as day, bro. You could just see it. And it changed my life forever. I think I was 19 when I seen that, and I was just like, I didn't even know. I knew the girl too, so I was just like, yeah, I couldn't believe that. Well, at least I know she wasn't racist.
I can't understand you. Go back to your country, white power.
But yeah, I definitely knew that she was an equal opportunist because, I mean, she had a white guy and a black guy up in that room. But yeah, that's one of my more crazier stories that happened or that I experienced in boot camp. I have a few other crazier ones, but I think that one was one of the first to pop up. But yeah, that was pretty interesting. Actually, I kind of forgot all about that, but it's whatever. Yeah, so I will catch you guys next time.
Did we get too close? Let's have a toast. Let's do the most. Let me be a good host, baby. Let's get close. Whoa, baby, let's get close.
All right, so that's the end of my video. And in case you're wondering where I get all my cool aerial footage from, it's coming from Unic Q500 series. I'm gonna go ahead and leave a link in the description so that you can purchase one in case you have an interest in doing so. December, Christmas. I'd recommend getting a complete package because it comes with your controller and it comes with a lot of various other items such as two batteries. It comes with an analog like gimbal controller, and the camera is really what you're paying for. You can detach it and attach it to other items, so it's really good to have. So you could have it as like I know GoPro has it where you can actually, you know, hold the camera and it's stable. It has something like that and it's battery powered and it levels out the entire camera itself. So I'd actually recommend getting the complete package that comes with a carrying case as opposed to just buying all the items individually. But yeah, that's where I'm getting all my aerial footage is at. It's getting dark outside, as you can see. And I'm probably gonna head in. It's been a good day. Tokyo to LA. Peace out.